Hi, welcome back to our channel and back to the tutorial for computer networks. Today we are going to see the topic called socket programming in computer networks. So we are going to discuss the basics here. So before going to this topic, we have to know what is socket. So socket is nothing but we can say it's interface between application and network. So it's a interface between application network. And the question now, why we need this? We need the socket programming. What we need means to, if you want build any network application, that time we need support a socket program concept here. Let's say example, you can say WWF TP and so on. And moreover, you can say the best example is Firefox or you can say Internet Explorer. So whenever you want, you can access the internet and resources. Whatever the resources want, you can get it here. Let's say one more example. Example, you can say before going that deeply about this concept. Yeah, so you can say here a socket is an abstraction over a communication flow. Also, you can say moreover, socket programming is a way of connecting two nodes on a network to communicate with each other. So, two nodes want to communicate, two machines want to communicate. That time in support of socket program only. One socket listens on a particular port. At an IP, where other socket reaches out to the other to form a connection. So let's go for the example here. So let's assume that there will be a telephone connection. So let's assume that the telephone and the two persons there, one telephone connection is there. So one telephone, another telephone. Let's have a connection with the public network. So here, what are the transactions going here? Means, thing in general was telephone call. So telephone call over a telephone network here. So whenever want to communicate, one person may communicate to another person via public network only. So here, what are the process key means? Here every telephone. So every person have an individual telephone number. Okay, remember. So whenever the person let's assume the A want to communicate to B, the A should be now is contact number. So whenever the telephone number of A B knows, you can call and communicate. Here process started here. So here phone number call and both can take and exchange data. So at a time what happened, both a person can communicate, and if the person B is pick up the call, they can communicate and exchange data. At last everything over, they can stop the process. So similar mechanism followed in our socket programming also. So here there's a diagram given here. So it's a general diagram. Moreover, before going this, you have to know what is the need of socket here. System call, there was a lot of system calls supported by this socket programming. Socket here, the first one is it's for creating the endpoint for communication. So if it's always create the endpoint for the communication here, and bind for assigning a unique thing, and receive from at last send to and close, and send to receive. And socket like that. So moreover, remember the communication here the socket program always follow the communication model that is called a client server model only. Remember, so here let's assume and compare with the telephone network, the A and B communicating like that. Here socket in the sense what, creating endpoint and bind for combining, that means assigning a unique telephone number and listen for wait for a caller. And then you can say connection is that is for dial a number, and accept is that means receive a call, and send and receive, and talk at last, send and receive. So a person here communicating means what, B can come here also. Whenever the user or who are using the internet, they can access the internet. So whenever they access internet, let's say example Internet Explorer is one of the web client which requests those pages from the server. So through the server, it requests from the information from the server and get it and forward to the client here. So overall process happening like this only when I come to the concept of socket programming. So remember, socket means what? It's interface between application network. What we need means to build any network application. If you want to build any network application like WWF, FTP and so on, we need support of socket only. So these are the fundamentals of socket programming. If you have any queries or suggestions, please kindly communicate with the following social media. And thanks for watching. If you like the video, please subscribe and share with your friends. Thank you.